Hey people, welcome to the Run Test. It's Kieran here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about this. Is the Veja Marlin. It is a shoe that's made from 62% bio-based and recycled material, so it's got some green credentials. It's from Veja, who are known for their eco-friendly footwear. It follows on from the Condor 2 and is lighter and more angled at performance. It's actually named after one of the ocean's fastest and most athletic fish, the marlin. But does it really live up to that billing? Is it a great catch, or should we throw it back? You're going to find out in our first run review. So let's whip quickly through some of the details. Well, this is a neutral road running shoe. Veja says it's designed for fast comfort on the roads. It will handle a little bit of light off-road, you know, park paths, that kind of thing, but mainly designed for tarmac and asphalt. It's lighter than the Condor 2, so it's Veja's lightest performance running shoe to date. It comes in at 288 grams, that's 10.1 ounces in your US money, and that's compared to the 301 grams that the Condor 2 was, so it is lighter. It's got a 6mm drop. The Veja Condor had a 10mm drop, so you've got a lower drop too. You're getting 24 mils stack height in the back, in the heel there, and 18 in the forefoot. So the midsole is made from 60% sugarcane. You've also got two what are called L-foam inserts, one above the heel, which is a 4mm, and one above the forefoot, which is 2mm. That's latex-based inserts. They're there to absorb shock and deliver some energy return. That's the idea anyway. On the top, you've got a one-piece V-knit upper, different to what you had in the Condor. It's really breathable. You can actually see your fingers wiggle through it. The tongue here is nice and padded. It's nice and wide as well, so it wraps across the whole top of the foot, and really helps when you've got trying to get that locked down with the laces, not to have any sort of pinch across the top of the foot. It's gusseted, but not fully sort of booty. The heel collars here as well, they're well padded, but without overdoing it. They're nice kind of plush sort of comfort, but without being over padded. So there's a bit of weight saving that's happened there. You're also going to get a heel counter here that adds a little bit of structure and support on the outer. And there's a few kind of overlays to note that add a little bit of extra structure to that knit upper. This kind of V here, which is made from TPU, I believe, and you've got some more on the outside here. The other thing I should say is there's a removable insole. In terms of those kind of eco credentials as well, that insole is made from 72% bio-based and recycled materials. That's 51% sugarcane and 21% recycled plastic bottles. Flip it over, and on the outsole, you have got rubber overlays here for durability. They are split here, so these flex grooves, Veja says they're flex grooves that are supposed to, like most flex grooves, move with your feet and help you have a bit of a more natural kind of flow and style. This rubber is Amazonian. It's got 65% bio-based, 32% Amazonian rubber, 33% rice-based, and it's kind of grippy enough, found no problem on the roads with that. On the uppers, this lacing structure reinforced, and I guess that's there to add durability. You do have these kind of stitched hooks as well, but it's reinforced and goes through the actual upper. That's actually sort of offers really good kind of lockdown fit security that I've found. In terms of pricing, you're going to pay £145 in the UK, $180 in the US, and that's 160 euros. Quick word on fit. I ran in a UK 8.5, which is true to size. I found these shoes were a little bit long in the toe box without really being necessarily wide in the toe box. That mesh upper does make you feel like you've got a lot of wiggle room with the toes, but actually there was quite a chunk at the end of this shoe that was a little bit too long in the toe box. The other thing I will say, when I first put them on, even with any amount of adjusting of the laces, I found this section here, right at the bottom of that lacing sort of housing, was really tight across the top of my midfoot. I have got quite a high instep and I've got quite fat feet, but that was initially quite uncomfortable. No matter how much I've tweaked with these laces, it did ease off after 10Ks and walking around in them quite a lot. It loosened off and it's no longer a problem, but initially it was a little bit of a worry and a little bit of a concern on the fit. Overall, I'd basically say that these have quite a narrow, quite a long fit. Feels a little bit odd on my high insteps and my kind of fat feet. Having said that, I think if I were to go half a size up, I think they'd definitely be a lot too long in the toe. So I'm out for my second run test in the Veja Marlin. I've done 6 miles, which is fairly kind of slow and easy so far. And now I've got something a little bit up tempo. I've got to do a VO2 max session, which means I'm going to have to pick up the pace. And then I'll be able to give you my full sort of first run verdict on these high performance, eco-friendly shoes from Veja. So let's go and do some hard work and I will see you after. So I'm just in the middle. Got a little recovery walk here because I can't jog at the moment at the pace I'm running. And actually, first thing I've noticed about these Marlins, second time out,
is that all of that tightness that was in the forefoot on the upper has gone. They feel sort of very, very comfortable now. Those mesh uppers have sort of just flexed a little bit, and now they're very comfy across the top of my foot. They do still feel a little bit baggy in the toe. They are definitely a little bit long. Plenty of room, we're going for the toes, width-wise, but there's just a little bit too long in the toe. And I think that would be a problem if I went half a size up to give a little bit more room around the rest of the shoe. But actually, they feel much more comfortable with this second miles out. The firmness at a faster pace. Also, you know, you're not getting the spring in response, I don't think you'll find from other shoes that you might use to do a session like this. They're very firm. You have to be basically doing the work here. I don't necessarily dislike that. Some people will. Anyway, 20 seconds before my next rep. Two more minutes of suffering to go. I'll be back after this. So there you have it. I'm just off my VO2 max session, which is basically lots of 2 minute intervals with 2 minute recoveries, 2 minute intervals at a higher pace, sort of 5:30 minute per mile pace for me at 175 heart rate, which is kind of high and fast. So putting these shoes to the test over that. And yeah, I mean, here's my verdict right now after doing those two runs, a slower run and a faster run. Basically, you don't get instant step in comfort when you put these on for the first time, these Marlins. That has to come with a few runs. There are some shoes you put them on, they feel great from the off. The Marlin isn't one of them, but after these two runs, they've settled down. It feels like they've widened a little bit across the top of the midfoot, and that is now comfortable. The mesh is nice and flexy, hugs the foot in the right places. The lace setup holds down nice and firm. There's no slipping for me in the heel. They do feel a little bit sort of baggy in the toe lengthwise rather than widthwise. That's a little bit of an odd sensation. I think these shoes do feel come a little bit sort of long and narrow. I've gone true to size in the UK 8.5 here, and I think I would have to stick with that. I think compared to the Condor, they're definitely lighter and more performance friendly. The Condors are sort of heavier. There's a whole lot more shoe to the Condor too than these Marlins. So Marlin taking a step forward in terms of producing a good performance shoe. They're also, so I think, lighter than something like the Allbirds Dasher and the Dasher Mizzle. They're not quite as performance friendly, I wouldn't say, as the Salomon Index, which I've also run in. The Salomon Index feel a little bit more like a traditional shoe. There's a little bit more foam going on in the midsole of the Salomon Index, and I think they're a little less firm. The one overall thing with all of the eco shoes that I've worn, aside from the Reeboks, which I haven't tested, are they do run firm. The Condor ran firm, the Condor 2 ran firm, and these Marlins still run firm. You are not gonna get loads and loads of sort of squish and release response from these shoes. You will feel a lot of direct contact with the ground. I personally quite like that. I think it's okay when I'm smashing out laps like this. I don't know if I would go longer than a sort of 10k at a fast pace in these. I'm maybe up to a half marathon, but I wouldn't want to be in them for, like, you know, longer than like an hour and a half tops. An hour is probably ideal. You know, the thing is, I've just come out of a Pegasus 38, the Nike Pegasus 38. And again, you know, it's the stark difference here in terms of that cushioning. The Peg 38 feels like, you know, you're squishing into sand compared to this firm ride. So it will depend very much where you fall on that firmness debate. If you like a firm shoe, you might like these. The mesh upper is great. I think that's kind of comparable to a lot of other shoes. I feel like they do support. Stability was fine. The 6mm drop, again, maybe a little bit challenging for some people if you're used to a much higher drop than that, but I don't mind that. I quite like that. So yeah, overall, I think having done those two runs, just come off this fast one, I would say that this is probably a better shoe than the Condor and the Dasher for a sort of daily trainer when you're going to do shorter or faster miles. It's a little bit more performance than a casual shoe, but it is not performance in the sense of some other shoes that we know and love from the other brands. It's much better than the Condor. I would say that it's a little better actually than the Dasher. And yeah, I don't quite think it's up there with the Salomon Index, which I still think, apart from the Reebok, is my favorite eco-friendly running shoe in terms of how they perform. So I guess the other thing I really wanted to mention was price. And at £145, these are not cheap shoes by any stretch. I think you're definitely going to be able to find shoes at that price that probably perform better overall for pure kind of running. But I guess if you've got your one eye on the environment and you believe that these are more environmentally sound shoes, then that may be an investment that you're willing to make in order to have a little bit of better eco conscience. It's maybe a decision that we all need to make. These prices, will only ever come down probably if more people invest in the materials that are being produced to create them. At the moment, I guess there's that kind of whole supply and demand means that the prices in the manufacturing is higher than it might be if there was a bigger demand. But yeah, at the moment, I would say that Veja Marlin are probably on the more expensive side for what you get out of them for a shoe.
So after about 13 miles in, my initial first run verdict on the Veja Marlin is that these are easily Veja's best running performance shoes to date. They are the shoes that kind of you'd most sort of liken to a traditional kind of running shoe. The Condor, I felt, you know, might have been good up to kind of a max of a half marathon distance, but they ran a bit firm. They didn't really feel like running shoes the moment you put them on. This is definitely a step towards Veja producing shoes that you would really kind of think, yeah, they're definitely designed for running, not for kind of a bit more kind of lifestyle running kind of crossover. They're not all the way there yet. For many people, I think these are still going to come up a little bit firm. And I've said this with all of the eco shoes that I've tested. A lot of what's going on here is in the midsole, really. The foams that I've experienced so far, some people have said some of the Reeboks are very different and offered a little bit more springy kind of responsiveness. A lot of the foams just run a lot more firm than a lot of the shoes that we're seeing of late. Now, it really will depend on where you stand on that kind of firm cushioning debate. If you really like something that's kind of does that soft compress, big spring back, then I don't think you get this. You get a kind of firmer, more direct run underfoot on these. I quite like it. And I could happily go out and run casual miles in this. I would sometimes, you know, they would be capable of doing some faster, poppier stuff. I wouldn't really want to take them further than half a marathon. I actually just think they're still just in that market of being more of a casual running shoe that can do a little bit of performance rather than being an all-out performance running shoe when you put them up against the other competition. Having said that, I think the uppers are good. The fit was a little bit odd initially, but having worn my way into them, I didn't mind it after a while. I think this is a really, really good kind of step forward for Veja. It moves them more into the ballpark of competition with your more traditional running shoes that wouldn't necessarily be considered eco-friendly, and that is definitely going to be a good thing. I do hope they continue to kind of innovate in this and keep moving in the right direction because, you know, they are taking steps forward. So overall, probably good for shorter, faster runs where you don't mind having a bit of firmness underfoot, but up to an hour probably max, I would say. But maybe they still don't give you the protection that you might want if you're going beyond an hour on your feet. So there you have it. That's my first run verdict of the Veja Marlin. If you have any questions, ask us in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out the channel. We've got other videos of other eco-friendly shoes on there for comparison. We've done the Veja Condor too. We've done the Allbirds Dasher and the Dasher Mizzle. Those are some that might be in this bracket. And yeah, thanks for watching. We've been the Run Testers and we hope to see you again soon.